Now we'll take a look at what happens when we take our equation ideas and apply them to problems with fractions. These problems look very onerous, but they're actually not that bad as long as you know the one trick to them, which is to clear the fractions. Clearing the fractions, if you do it correctly, will make the problem very, very simple because, true to its name, you won't have any fractions in there anymore. We do that by multiplying by the LCD, the lowest common denominator of every denominator that you see. In order to clear the fractions, you need to multiply by each term on both sides. Let's take a look at example one here. Here we have three denominators, 6, 2, and 4. We're going to clear the fractions by multiplying by a number that is divisible by 6, 2, and 4. If you haven't found LCDs in a while, remember it's very easy. The trick is just to prime factorize all of your denominators. 2 is already prime, that's easy. 4 works out to 2 squared. 6 works out to 2 times 3. Then we put it all together. And remember, for the LCD, you just take the highest power of whatever you see. In this case, we get 2 squared times 3, which is 12. So our LCD is 12. Now, we're just going to multiply all three terms by 12. So we'll have 12 times 3/4 minus 12 times 1/2 equals 12 times 5 over 6. Now, there are a couple different ways to do this. What I find works best for me is to simplify as I go. Remember, this is considered 12 over 1. All the way across. So you can divide 12 by 4 and get 3 over 1, divide 12 by 2 and get 6 over 1, and divide 12 by 6 and get 2 over 1. Then all the ones on the bottom you can ignore because dividing by 1 doesn't do anything. 3 times 3x equals 9x minus 6 equals 2 times 5 is 10. Now, this is why we call it clearing the fractions, because now this ugly looking fractional equation has become something very, very simple. This looks exactly like the kinds of problems we've been looking at lately. And of course, we just do the same things we've been doing then. Add 6 to both sides. We'll get that 9x equals 16. And then, of course, we divide by 9. And we get here that x equals 16 over 9. The second problem works the exact same way. We're just going to find the LCD of all three denominators. We find the simplest or smallest number that is divisible by 5, 10, and 15. Again, if you ever don't know how to do that, it always works to prime factorize all three numbers and just find the simplest thing that contains all of the above. 5 is prime. 10 is 5 times 2, and 15 is 5 times 3. So if I compile something that includes all three factors, I'll have 5 times 2 times 3, which is 30. So now, just as I divided by 12 in example 1, I'm going to divide by 30 here. And again, if it's more comfortable for you, you can call this 30 over 1. It doesn't make a huge difference either way. I'll use both in this equation because it's a little easier to write 30 over 1 for fractions, whereas for that integer there, which we do need to incorporate, it's a little easier to just put 30. So now I'll just write everything we have for the original equation. 3/5 x minus 7/10. Notice I'm multiplying every single term as I go across here. Little typo, that's a 1 down there, not a 4. Sorry about that. And then here we get negative 4 plus this times 7 over 15. And don't forget the x. Now we just simplify yet again. 30 divided by 5 is 6. 30 divided by 10 is 3. There's nothing to divide here because there are no fractions. So just leave that until the next step. And then 30 divided by 15 is 2. Now, 6 times 3x is 18x. Minus 3 times 7 is 21. Then I get negative 120. Then 2 times 7 is 14x. And now we got what we wanted. Now we've taken this circuitous looking expression and made it something much, much, much simpler. And now we do the same thing we've been doing. We have two variable terms, so we need to unite them. In this case, you can either subtract 18x from both sides, or you can subtract 14x from both sides. If you do it right, you get the same answer either way, so it doesn't make a tremendous difference. Negative 21 equals negative 120 minus 4x. Then I can handle this by adding 120 to both sides. 120 minus 21 is 99, therefore 99 equals negative 4x. Again, we finish this off by dividing by negative 4, and we get that x equals negative 99 over 4. Remember, if a fraction is negative, it doesn't really matter where the minus goes in the fraction. You could attach it to the 99, to the 4, or just off to the side here as I did. So practice these. I realize they look very difficult, but you'll find that there's only one real new step here, and it just builds off of things that you already knew. Give this a shot, and I think you'll surprise yourself by how easy it actually is.